Sportsmen and late models, for that matter, they need you in staging for qualifying. Here comes the field out of turn four, and it's on at I-75. Lackey in the 4L with a bit of an advantage. Well, for the time being, now it's Banks in the 127. However, there comes Jamie Lackey to the bottom. All of that for nothing. Caution flag out. 88 of Burgess ends up partially on the infield over there in turn two. Caution flag showing.
GJ Pistons, Wilwood Disc Brakes, Kaiser Aluminum Wheels, Saldana Racing Products, Pyrotech, and Brown & Miller Racing Solutions. Green flag back in the air, Brian Call. We're back for the restart.
Matt Banks in the 127 out in front over the four. Pat Lackey, 44 of Jamie Lackey. That is a father-son combination. Jamie Lackey, the son, moving into the second position. Pat Lackey falls to third. And now Jamie Lackey, second's not good enough. He's going for the lead, and he's got it down the back straightaway. New race leader, 44 of Jamie Lackey. Lackey continues to lead the way ahead of Marshall Banks. And then Pat Lackey in the third position. Sportsman drivers, guys, we need you in staging. Looks like most of you are over there for qualifying. Jamie Lackey continues to lead the way here at I-75. He has won a few feature races the last couple of years here at this beautiful Tim and Angie Kyle owned facility. Lackey pulling away from the field. He has pretty much a straightaway on the rest of the field. Jamie Lackey certainly in control of this B Hobby heat race. Lackey all by himself over on the back straightaway. A pretty good battle for second, though. Marshall Banks trying to hold on for second. Pat Lackey on his rear bumper. White flag in the air. We're on the final lap. Jamie Lackey getting set to go down the back straightaway as the battle is still on for second. Jamie Lackey, unless something crazy happens, is going to win this heat race. Here he comes out of turn four. The checkered flag flies for Jamie Lackey. Second, still up in the air. Marshall Banks, Pat Lackey coming out of turn four. 127 of Banks is scored in second. All right, getting set to go with this Thunder Division heat race, and we're green flag racing. Jonathan Hampton, Audie Wyrick, and Alan Walker, they go down the back straightaway. Hampton looking to take his second consecutive Thunder Division feature win tonight. Of course, we're in heat race action right now, still preliminary action. Hampton the leader with one lap scored. Jonathan Hampton, the 16-year-old, he's a sophomore, McMinn County High School. Hampton looking to lead the second lap as he comes out of turn four, and he does so. Alan Walker in second, Audie Wyrick in third. This race is zipping right along, four-cylinder, both heat races. We need you in staging now, both four-cylinder heat races, as we near the halfway point of this Thunder heat race. And Hampton is the leader at the halfway point over Alan Walker and Audie Wyrick. Hampton over on the back straightaway as we look to put another circuit in the books with Jonathan Hampton showing the way in the 14 machine. Hampton continues to lead with four laps scored over Alan Walker and Audie Wyrick. Hampton leading the way, and we're on the white flag lap. Jonathan Hampton in control over Alan Walker and Audie Wyrick. It'll be the checkered flag in the air the next time for Jonathan Hampton. Hampton out of turn four, and the checkered flag waves for Jonathan Hampton, followed by Alan Walker and Audie Wyrick scored in third. Win show, and here comes the field out of turn four, and it's on at I-75. David Singleton, Michael Courtney down the back straightaway. Courtney jumps out to the advantage. Michael Courtney, in the last decade or so, perhaps the all-time winningest driver in East Tennessee in four-cylinder racing. He is always a threat to win. Donnie Turpin in the five on the high side, looking to take over the second position from David Singleton, and he completes the pass. Turpin will look to reel in Michael Courtney. Easier said than done. Courtney well out in front. Donnie Turpin in second. David Singleton looking to hold on for third over Derek Dugan and then Larry Housley. We look to put lap three on the board. We have reached the halfway point with Michael Courtney in the lead. This will determine the inside row for our feature later on tonight for the four-cylinder division. Courtney leading the way with four laps officially scored. Correction, three laps on the board. Courtney leading the way. Four laps on the board. Courtney leading the way. Michael Courtney leads the field out of turn four. White flag in the air as we enter the final lap. Michael Courtney in control. Down the back straightaway. Checkered flag will wave this time for Michael Courtney unless something crazy happens. Here he comes out of turn four, and the checkered flag waves. Courtney the winner, followed by Donnie Turpin, Derek Dugan, David Singleton. Turn four, and it's on this time in the four-cylinder heat race. Marcus Thompson out in front. Jimmy Lankford, the birthday guy, moving into second. Dustin Pruitt up to third, and David Long in the fourth position. Thompson looks like he's going to be the leader after lap one, and it's in the books. Marcus Thompson followed by Jimmy Lankford, Dustin Pruitt, and then Dustin Long rounding out the field. David Long rounding out the field. Thompson looking to complete another circuit out in front. Two laps officially scored. Marcus Thompson looks to be in control of this second four-cylinder heat race. Front-wheel drive, guys, you should be ready. Pruitt in the 48 will exit the racetrack, our track champion, pulling off in this heat race. Halfway point with Marcus Thompson leading the way over Jimmy Lankford and David Long in the D7. Four-cylinder heat race number two, we're halfway home. Front-wheel drive will be the final heat race of the evening. One more to come, and then it's feature time. Marcus Thompson continues the lead. As he goes down the back straightaway, Thompson all by himself over on the back straightaway. Marcus Thompson in turn three and the white flag in the air as Marcus Thompson is on the final lap. This should put Marcus Thompson on the outside front row for our feature later on tonight. As long as everything's good when he crosses the scales at the end of this race. Thompson to the checkered flag. Second will be the 44 of Jimmy Lankford, and David Long in the D7 will be scored in third. All right, race fans, we have one more heat race on the evening. It'll be the front-wheel drive division. Following the front-wheel drive heat race...